what we're likely to see on appeal in the Alex Murdaugh trial. Fiume once here, driving instructor of the world. So this judge let in evidence, circumstantial evidence, but evidence that it said could only use to motive. In other words, the jury could only consider it as to why Alex may have done the crime. This is part of the circumstantial evidence that the prosecution said they were going to make in their case, they were going to use in their case. However, these circumstances had nothing to do with the actual June 7th incident. He let in Alex's drug habit. There's no proof, no clear link that that went to Alex's motive or the incident of dispatching Paul and Maggie. The jury said, well, they felt like Alex was lying. They didn't believe his character. The drug abuse goes to Alex's character. That could be a huge problem in terms of the law. The judge also let in the roadside incident in September that had nothing to do with the June 7th incident. He let it in as a consequence of financial crimes. But the financial crimes also had nothing to do with the June 7th incident, and he let in all of them. He could have let in just the one, the incident where Alex is confronted that day at work. $789,000 seemed to be misplaced. Alex's excuse that day is he wants to set up an annuity to hide money for the boathouse case, so it couldn't be taken. She says she doesn't want a part of that, but there was nothing else suspicious that he was doing. There was nothing about he was hiding or stealing money at that point. She had no knowledge. In fact, Alex works the regular day, the rest of the day, even though his dad goes into the hospital that day. Alex even calls her later and says, hey, can we talk about my 401ks? Showing that he didn't think there was any conflict between the two of those people, himself and the agent at the office. For the judge to let in all those other 99 financial crimes where he lies to clients, where he steals money, that goes to his characters. And the jurors say they didn't believe him. He's a liar. They did not get that from any evidence that pertained to the June 7th incident. Because at that day, up to that time, we had no knowledge, no one did, that Alex was stealing, that Alex was on drugs, that Alex would try to stage or try to unalive himself in September. This goes to law. And it will be the basis for the Court of Appeals. Now, the Court of Appeals is a little bit different in South Carolina. It does go to three judges. You cannot bring any new evidence, but it doesn't go to an appeals court like every other crime does. It goes right to a district court. So we'll see what happens, but these will be huge basis for the defense's appeals. On the road of life, please drive kind. And thank you for following. And liking. I mean, I like you.